वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट्स, इट इज़ द पार्ट नंबर 7 ऑफ लेसन ऑफ टॉपिक एक्सक्रीशन एंड लेसन द लाइफ प्रोसेस। टुडे वी हैव सम इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक दैट वी आर गोइंग टू कवर। फर्स्ट सम डेफिनेशन रिगार्डिंग द मिक्चुरेशन एंड ऑस्मोरेगुलेशन, एंड द सेकेंड टॉपिक इज द आर्टिफिशियल किडनी एंड द कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट ऑफ यूरिन। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट टुडेज क्लास। Hope you all are happy and fine and you are ready to study. So keep all your pen, pencils and your copies together and try to understand. If you are having any kind of problem, you can ask at me at any time, at any place. Okay, so let's study. First of all, micturition. So whenever you go to pass out your urine, whenever you go to pass out your urine, you in the impulse of the brain, your brain says to go to the bathroom to pass out your urine. So it is called micturition. Passing out urine through urethra in the impulse from the nervous system is called micturition. I think you understood. So micturition means passing of urine in the impulse of the brain. When brain says, then you go to pass out it. It is called osmoregulation. Next comes osmoregulation. Osmoregulation, what is osmoregulation? The kidney maintain the proper limit of or proper amount of salt and water into the body, and the extra water and salt is passed out through the urine. So maintaining the level of the salt and water in the body is done by kidney, and this help in the proper osmosis in the different part of the body. So it control or it regulate the osmosis of the body with the maintaining the water and level of the salt into the body, into the blood. This is called osmoregulation. Let's study. So while removing the waste from the blood, the kidney also maintain and require the percentage of water and mineral into the body, thus regulate the osmotic pressure of the blood, and this is called osmoregulation. It is very important and vital. If osmosis will not take place in the proper way, the cell that is required to get any kind of substances in and out will not take place, means osmosis will not regulate. So the level of salt and level of water is very important to maintain, and it is done by the kidney. I think you understood this topic. So osmoregulation, kidney controls or kidney regulate the osmotic pressure, and it is called osmoregulation. Now what are the different constituent of urine? When you pass out the urine, what are the different kinds of organic and inorganic substances that the urine contain? First of all, urine contain about 99% water. Along with that, some organic substances are also there. That is urea. Urea, how much urea? 2.3 gram per liter. Creatinine, 1.5 gram per liter. Uric acid, 0.7 gram per liter. And other means there are some other organic substances may be there. So it will be 2.6 gram per liter. In case of inorganic substances, so what are the different inorganic substances that is excreted out through urine? That it is sodium chloride, that is salt, 9.0 gram per liter. Potassium chloride, 2.5 gram per liter. Ammonia, that is a gas, 0. Obviously it is very dissolvable in the water, so it is also dissolved, 0.6 gram per liter, and another 2.5 gram per liter. So it is the constituent of urine that you have studied. Now the topic that is a very vital topic that we are going to cover here, artificial kidney and dialysis. Suppose your kidney or anyone's kidney has been damaged due to any reason, either by taking some drugs, some hard chemical drugs, or by any kind of accident or injury. So what will happen? The kidney actually filter out all the unwanted and poisonous waste, and if it is get damaged, it cannot be able to filter out these poisonous waste. So that this poisonous waste will obviously mix into the blood and move throughout the body. And when this poison goes to the brain, it paralyzes the brain, and the brain cannot able to work. And at that time, it can cause the death of the patient. I think you understood. So it is very necessary to have a healthy kidney. Or if it is get damaged, and that time blood is filtered out, or all the poisonous substances that is present in the blood is filtered out by artificial kidney. And filtering out of this process is called dialysis of the blood. Let's study. This leads to the accumulation of the poisonous waste. I already told you, which can even lead to the death of the patient if the kidney get damaged and not working properly at that time. So in case of kidney failure, the artificial kidney can be used. And the artificial kidney is a device that helps in the removal of nitrogenous waste product from the blood through dialysis. I think you are understanding very well all the topic that I am teaching over here. So let's study how the kidney or artificial kidney help in the dialysis or help in the separating the poisonous substances from the blood. The figure is already given in the book, thus I have not given the figure over here. Artificial kidney contain a number of tubes. The figure is given in the book. You can see this type of tube, and this tube contain with a semi-permeable lining. This tube has a semi-permeable lining. Semi-permeable means, yeah, selectively permeable. So it can easily select all the essential ingredient and thrown out all non-essential ingredient. And the tube is filled with a dialyzing fluid. Dialyzing fluid means the fluid which help to filter out, or the fluid that help in dialysis of the blood. So there are two vital things. What are they? The semi-permeable membrane or the semi-permeable lining of the tube, and the tube filled with a dialyzing fluid. This fluid has the same osmotic pressure as blood. Means the pressure exerted by blood is also as same as the tube that is present over there. So it can easily help to throw out the nitrogenous waste. So the fluid has a same osmotic pressure as blood, except that is devoid of nitrogenous waste. The patient blood is passed through the tubes. Tubes will, semi-permeable lining help to filter out it, and the pressure exerted as the pressure exerted into the blood. During this passage, the waste product from the blood pass out through the dialyzing fluid by diffusion, and the purified blood is pumped into the patient. So from here, if the blood is bring out and entered into the tube is filtering all the blood, and again from other side the blood is entering in this artery, or sorry, this vein. So you can say the patient body, from the patient body, the blood is exerted from one side and filtered into the artificial kidney, and again returned back to the another side. And this is continue for a long hour, about 6 to 7 hours. Understood? This is similar to the function of a kidney. So artificial kidney act as same as the original kidney, but obviously it take a lot of time. Remember, a normal kidney filter out about 180 liter daily, but in case of artificial kidney, you have to filter the blood twice in a week, because if the kidney is not working properly, after one filtration, within 2 to 3 days, it accumulates a lots of water, salt, as well as unwanted poisonous substances in the body. So within 3 to 4 days, it needed to be get filtered out. Understood? However, the volume actually, so our blood is filtered how many times? How much volume? 180 liter daily. But how much do we excrete out? we excrete only a liter or two, means 1 liter or 2 liter in a day. Whole day we excrete out urine about 1 or 2 liter. So you can think how many times it get absorbed. 178 liter of blood is reabsorbed by PCT, DCT and Lupa family. So kidney tubules are very active over here, and you should keep it healthy. So you should know what are the things that makes your kidney healthy, and do not take any kind of unwanted substances, drugs, wine or this kind of things that can cause the damage of the kidney. Understood? Hope for your better learning. I think you understood. If you have any kind of problem, you can ask me at any time, any place. I am always ready to help you. And be prepared your homework and send it to me. Okay, bye bye, see you.